Vice President for Athletes for Hope. And Ellie, you just got done with your social responsibility panel. Can you give us a little recap about what you guys spoke of in front of the students upstairs?
Absolutely. First we got into a fight and then we beat each other. No, I'm just kidding. Sorry. The panel was a opportunity for several different perspectives. So we had the CEO of a program nonprofit that works with the extra tickets amongst all these teams. We had the amazing Israel from here at Nationals Park who does all the community relations. And then I represented the perspective of the athletes because we work directly with the athletes. So we had an opportunity to talk about sort of what's on the horizon, what's innovative, what's interesting, where our personal motivations came for our work that we do and how we got here, how we literally got into the jobs that we're in, and then some of what we think is some of the best work that we've seen out there.
And you mentioned that Athletes for Hope obviously does work with the athletes. You, your company just had their fundraiser, and it's just, can you kind of give us a little feedback about how that went, what it's like to get the athletes involved with the community and see an outcome from that?
Absolutely. I think my favorite part about Athletes for Hope is that although we're founded by 12 of the world's most legendary philanthropic athletes, our program works with athletes from all Olympic sports, Paralympic sports, and professional sports, many of whom nobody will ever know their name. And their ability to give back is as powerful as Lance Armstrong's or Mia Hamm's because of the fact that sports provides that platform. And those who embrace it, when you know that they have that fear of sort of, will anybody really respond and will anybody notice me and, you know, will I be able to do as much with this as I hope? And you see the passion and the drive they have, the variety that we get to work with, the diversity of athletes and the diversity of causes that they care about. It's awesome and fun. It's really fun because they never give up.
So then for a young student who's trying to break into the sports business or perhaps working with athletes or nonprofits or whatever they want to do, is passion the one thing that you suggest that they follow in terms of what they should do to get their foot in the door?
I think you have to have a lot of passion because it is very hard to be paid well. It is a very crowded marketplace and people are trying to get this and very enthusiastic about getting these opportunities. So I would combine passion with a real commitment to learn because there's a lot of learning curve about strategy and information that's deeper than, it's more business skill oriented than just loving sports. And in the end, if it's about figuring out a way to do social good as well, then you have to figure out how to take return on investment and make it mean more than just money and connect all the dots. So it's an interesting puzzle, and learning from graduate school to the moment of implementation and continuing on and being close to people that you can learn from and quite frankly, some of the people you can learn the most from is the person who drives you the most crazy and has a different perspective than you, because I think that's where I've learned the most important lessons in life.
And speaking of that, you are a professor at the Georgetown University Sports Industry Management Program that is hosting this fine CME event. Why is it important for you to come out and speak to the kids? Is it, you know, the feeling of letting them know about your experiences, being able to share them, or just letting them know that this actually is a possible opportunity that they could have for their futures?
It's really hard to say no to Matt Winkler for anything, and I think saying no to any of the students around here, because this is where we thrive on interns and we thrive on people that want to get into this field who are willing to help us. So I would never ever say no. I think it's fun, so that's the other reason that I try to make myself available for it, because there's only up to go. I think this is a growing and important field, particularly in the social responsibility area, that sports is going to figure it all out. It's been doing a lot, but there's global needs. You know, what just happened in Japan and elsewhere, people are trying to figure out how we make that something that we all play in. It's just a really interesting time for career.
That's great. So guys out there, if you want to get a job in social responsibility and or in the athlete world, you should definitely apply for those internships and go for your goals. So we want to thank Ellie for joining us and hope you had a good day.
Thank you.